said, we have to condition the public and to get them used to the idea of the dehumanization of human life. Before that, human life was at the pinnacle. Everyone had rights. You were a spiritual, physical being. And said, we have to get rid of that idea and make them think they're just one other animal. And through about 40, 50 years of intense propaganda, nature shows especially, all put out by the big foundations, we've been trained we're just another animal, nothing special at all. And because we're one of an animal, we have specialist animals above us who are better animals, more elitist animals and intellectuals. We should obey those ones. This is what the whole thing is about.
That's right, and humans are bad, and we have to be punished, and humans are a disease, just like that Club of Rome document from the early 90s, written by the current head of the CFR, Richard N. Haass. And it's more important, the brainwashing, even in the inner party, isn't it? A lot of the higher-level minions really believe they're doing a sacred work, putting cancer viruses in vaccines. Yeah, because we're bad. They've got to kill us to save the Earth. And after all, we're all just blobs. We're all just animals.
Charles Galton Darwin put it straight out in the 1950s, and he was a top physicist and grandson of Charles Darwin. He said that we must eventually start either euthanizing or sterilizing the masses, he says, because otherwise they'll bring their bad genes up into the good gene pool and destroy the good gene pool. This is how they rationalize what they plan to do. This Ted Turner, one of the big propagandists for the United Nations, we think these guys are all independent. They're not independent. In fact, they're brought up to be cultural leaders through the organizations and television systems and so on that they run. Ted Turner says at the United Nations, he says, a total population of 250 to 300 million people worldwide, which is a 95% decline from present levels, would be ideal. And he's the founder of CNN and a major UN donor and spokesman. The Club of Rome and their goals. Now, they have goals for mankind. This is not a wish list. They have goals set during a 10, 20, 50-year time period. They have long-term goals. This is a total population. They said the resultant ideal sustainable population is hence more than 500 million, but less than 1 billion. And that's in their own report called Goals for Mankind. We better realize that these guys are deadly serious, and they have the funding of the big five foundations, including the Rockefeller Foundations, to bring all this about. And they're doing it.
Alan Watt, do five more minutes with us. We got to get you up for 2 hours in the very near future. Do five more minutes with us. Then we have Niels Harrit, associate professor of the Department of Chemistry, University of Copenhagen for 37 years, doing his own study and finding what Stephen Jones and others found, the nano superthermite in the wreckage of the World Trade Center, the explosives used to blow it up. This is big international news. There's a blackout here domestically. We'll break that blackout straight ahead.
Are you concerned for the safety of your loved ones? Listen closely to this message from pepperspray.com. Every 22 seconds a violent crime is committed. America has changed, and your personal safety is your first priority. Be smart. Be safe. Trust Pepper Spray instead of your luck. Pepperspray.com is the only website you'll ever need for all of your non-lethal self-defense supplies. Pepperspray.com carries one of the largest assortments of pepper spray and personal safety products on the web. From big to small, we have it all. Pepper spray, mace, animal repellents, stun guns, and tasers. Pepperspray.com also carries a large assortment of products for personal, home, child, and pet safety. Enter SAFE in the coupon box and you'll receive a special discount off of your order. So what are you waiting for? Go to pepperspray.com. That's pepperspray.com. Or call 1-800-908-9988 today.
Second with Alan Watt, and we're going to focus in on some big 9/11 news. You know, we can't let this bird flu hoax that's giving them a police state, training the public for martial law, always introducing that idea for different reasons, terrorism, bio-attack, natural flus. We can't let that act as a smokescreen for the global carbon tax they're trying to pass in the U.S., the anti-gun treaties that will ban reloading and many types of rifles. This is happening right now. The new Bank of the World being set up will pay our carbon taxes, too. Israel saying they're about to attack Iran. It's all there. Pakistan saying nukes are missing with no evidence, totally made up. We have to continue to focus on it all and to expose these people. Alan Watt, you were getting into their goals and what the eugenics. I mean, simple. The eugenicists set up the world government on record. They're getting their world government right now, but not without a lot of people saying no. But the establishment said, as you know, 75, 80 years ago, that there would be a lot of, quote, beautiful, well-meaning people that had to die who would not want the New World Order. And H.G. Wells said, we're going to kill you.
Yeah.
But again, I really think that if we break the spell of mind control, we can beat these people.
We'd have to. And what we realize, too, is that these characters that claim that they're at the top go to the bathroom the same way as we do, and they go through all the same things. As they are not superhuman. They're just human beings and psychopaths who do believe. They believe they're superior, but in all reality, they're no more superior than any of us. We're all pretty well the same. So they have no rights to dictate how we should live. We have just as much right to dictate our own way of living and by ourselves.
But they have,
we're going to reclaim that right and say, no, get off my back. You can't tell me what to do. Go back and rule yourself. I will rule myself. That's what we have to do.
But, and I agree with you, they are hungry. They love the power. They love the control.
Yeah.
There are a lot of good people that are actually more intelligent than them. Just good people aren't that hungry. They don't enjoy crushing people. They don't want more power. Once you get a nice house and decent car and great wife and kids, you don't want any more. You don't want to go screw people to get things. They do. So I guess we've got to get our survival instinct to kick in.
We must do that, and very, very quickly, and start caring about each other and about ourselves, because you see, they've had a war on us and the family to isolate us all, isolation from us, each other. We all sit in front of computers, TVs, but we don't talk. And we've got to start communicating to each other and realize we have people living around us that we're supposed to communicate to and be part of and care about. And see, when you have something to care about, you will fight for it. That's why they have to destroy the family unit. Men would fight for the family, and they know that. And that's why the first target was the destruction of the family unit. They said that in their own writings.
CuttingThroughTheMatrix.com, CuttingThroughTheMatrix.com. Tell folks your European Mirror site for when the other one gets hacked.
Yeah, it's alanwattsentinel.eu, and they can get pretty well everything that's on the Sentinel, the other
site. And there's hundreds of audios and your books and DVDs, and folks should also buy some of that and support you because you're doing invaluable work. You know, Alan, let me say bye to you during the break because I had mentioned some things to you a few months ago, and now I'm more sure than ever that I want to work on something. Let me talk to you during the break, and then we've got our next guest coming up. But in the minute we've got left, because you always spur so much thought here, you're in your gut analyzing this. Do you think this flu thing right now is a total hoax?
It's a hoax, but here's what David Rockefeller said at the Club of Rome. Now, he's the executive manager of all these foundations, these front foundations. He says, we're on the verge of a global transformation. All we need is the right major crisis. Not reality, but crisis, you see? So they're using this, as I say, to gain more power over the public who are being petrified and punch drunk with conflicting documentation. And when they're conflicted like that and punch drunk, they're easily led. They'll cry, save us, and the world authorities will say, okay, now here we want it all signed into laws that we have power over you. That's what they're after.
Amazing. I tell you, Alan Watt, I've done so much research, and to hear you putting it out so smoothly and focused and expanding on it, I know what you're saying is accurate, and I just want to warn people. We really appreciate you joining us. Let me get you back up for a few hours so we can really get into depth in the next few weeks. There's Alan Watt. We'll be right back with our next guest, key information straight ahead, and a recap on the latest martial law news. Stay with us.
Thank you for listening to GCN. Visit GCNLive.com today.